Greetings all, welcome back, or welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Two-Stroke Town at the moment. This series is covering the equations as laid out by Professor Gordon Blair for designing an expansion chamber. So far we've done the first three's covered what we need to establish our tuned lengths. Now I've got some opinions on these that I'll sort of share with you towards the end of the video with regards to tune lengths and exact points where it's taken from, and there's kind of more to it, but at the moment we'll just stick to the equations and the process that Blair sets out for designing the pipe. And as I said before, even if you're not designing a pipe, it's handy to go through the process, because even if you're going to use modelling software, some of this will come into play and it'll make sense when you're actually going to use the software anyway. So now we've done our tuned lengths, we're going to move on to the next part, which is the diameters of the expansion chamber. Now, all of the diameters are all ratios, are all linked to the diameter of the port. So that's a round circle diameter. But as we know, the port is not normally a round port, an exhaust port. Now, what we have to do is we have to find some way of converting the shape of our exhaust port into a diameter or into a circle. So the best way to do that is to calculate the area, like a flat plane, like a pane of glass, the flat area. And first of all, we have to get the size of the ports, so we have to actually measure the ports. So there's a few parts to this. This is probably going to span a couple of videos. It's a little bit long, but stick with it. Again, we've got a little bit of mathematics. Yeah, I know. I'm a mechanic. I'm not that into it either. It's not too much here. It's not too hard. And once again, you can just use your Windows calculator to do this stuff. So the first thing we've got to do is actually measure our port. Now, our exhaust port, as we measure it for the purposes of the gas, the volume of the gas coming out, we measure a straight line value. Okay, so the area has to be a straight line value, because once the combustion's occurred, the piston moves down, pressure is completely equalized, there's equal pressure everywhere through the cylinder. When that piston opens, it's just going to go that way, right? So we have to measure it in terms of a flat face across here for area. And there's a number of ways of actually physically measuring the port, and the simplest way to do it, you can do it without the head off, or take the head off if you like, leave the cylinder on. You just need to measure it from one width across to the other side, okay, physically, which is the chord width, the direct line across. So to do that, you can just use a set of calipers like this, shove them up the port, wind them out until these two tips meet the edges here, and then holding onto this, you just squeeze those inwards, so you can pull the calipers out of the port and then let go of these back out to the stop, and then use a pair of vernier calipers or ruler, or vernier calipers preferably, to get some accuracy, and measure the width of the port. Okay, so that's the chord width of the port. Likewise, the height. All right, so once we've got the height of the port and the width of the port, then we can calculate our area, which is the height times the width. So if the height's in millimetres and the width is in millimetres, the area will be millimetres squared. So that's millimetres with a little slash and a little 2. So millimetres squared. Once we've got millimetres squared, we can then convert that into a diameter for the purpose of matching the round diameters of our pipe. So to get our diameter, we have to do another calculation. We take the area that we've calculated, and we've got a little calculation here. So we go 4 times our area divided by pi, write it down, or take that number, put it into your calculator, press the square root button, equals, and that is your number. And that number will be your diameter of the port area converted to a diameter. And then we take the diameter, and then we move on to the pipe calculations, which I will do. But first of all, we're going to go through a couple of other ways and a couple of other factors we've got to take into consideration. One is the radii in the port, or the radiuses, if you like, of the port. So obviously, if we were measuring a straight, square, sharp-edged rectangle, the area would be slightly larger, accounting for those little corners. So we've got to account for those radii in the corners there. I'll cover that. And then if we're measuring the port via another method of putting a piece of paper inside, the measuring like this, we put a piece of paper inside, we rub it with our fingers or whatever to put a mark on it where the port is, to mark out the rectangular kind of shaped port, or spray, a bit of spray paint up there, or we use a pencil, rub it side on and trace it on, so we get the pattern like this on a piece of paper. And what we can do then is we can convert it to a chord width, okay? Because when we lay the piece of paper out flat, we've still got this arc width. So any widths measured off this piece of paper for the purpose of this calculating the area of the port have to be turned from an arc width into a chord width first before doing this calculation, okay? You can't just calculate the widths of these as the area, because as I will show you, the wider the port is, the more difference there will be between the arc width and the chord width, okay? So we need to get that chord width, because we're talking about the gas flowing dead straight out the port. So we use this, again, we've got a calculation. We've got to take, to measure this chord width, we've got to take a pie slice out of here. That's an angle like that. So knowing our arc width and knowing our radius or diameter of the bore, we've got to find out what the angle is of that pie slice down at the center. So this is the first part of the equation. To do that, we take 2 times pi times the bore radius, which is half the diameter. Write it down. Take our arc width that we've calculated, okay? Being the curved one, we've calculated off our piece of paper, just measured directly off our piece of paper when we've flattened it out. Arc width divided by that first number we wrote down. So we've got a second number written down. Then we take 360 times that second number we've written down to give us our final number, which will be the angle there in degrees. So what we want to do is we want to turn that angle into radians. So we then take the number we've got, the angle in degrees, times pi divided by 180, turns it into radians. And that's for the next part of the calculation. So once we've got our angle in radians here, we divide that by 2, take that number resulting from that calculation, divided by 2, put it into your calculator, press the sine button, and get the value out of here, and that will give you the sine of this calculation, and then write that down, and then do the final equation, which is 2 times the bore radius, again, half the diameter of the bore, times that value you've written down, and you'll have the chord width, which is the width directly across the port that we need. And then, once that's known, you can then go back here, calculate your height times your chord width equals the area of the rectangle, and then calculate the diameter from the area to make it compatible with our port diameter calculations. We're up to 9 minutes. I'm going to leave the rest of it into the next video, and I will go through how to get the radii and subtract that from these values. I'll also cover odd-shaped ports and how to deal with those. So that will do it for today, and hopefully you can check out the next video. I've got a playlist for these particular ones for the building of the pipe. And please be sure to share the videos around if you can, if you enjoy the content, because, you know, YouTube's kind of burying the views of these later videos at the moment. It's just the way it does things. I don't know why, but it's life. So share the videos around because it gets to a point that if people aren't getting this information and making some use of it by going out and building a pipe and making their bike go faster or whatever, it kind of defeats the purpose of doing it. And it's not entertaining or interesting. And yeah, it's useful information only to people who are going to get some use from it. So it doesn't rate well in YouTube, and I'd appreciate it if you think others are interested. By all means, share the videos. And we'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.